you all completed your ST very well. So in this class we are going to start our new lesson children, that is block 6. So in that we are going to learn our S1. So before going to start our lesson, have you remember place value blocks children? Yes. So in the previous class we have learned about place value blocks. So for tens, which place value block we will draw? Yes, we will use tens tower to draw tens. See, for example, for tens, what we will use children? We will use ten tower. How it will be? It is just long strip and it has 10 ones cubes in that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So for tens, what we will use? We will use tens tower. How it will be? It will be like this. And for ones, what we will use? For ones, we will use ones cube. That is a small square and inside we have a dot. In 10 tower, we have how many ones, children? 10 ones. So, we will use 10 tower for tens and ones cube for ones. So, if I ask you to represent this 36 by using place value blocks, means how we will represent, children? First, we have to write place values. What we have to write, children? Place values. So, ones and tens. In 36, we have two place values. Those are ones and tens. So, how can we represent number by using place value blocks? We have to draw three 10 towers because in the tens place, we have three. So, three 10 towers. And how many ones cubes we have to draw? Six ones cubes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this will represent 36. So 36 we can represent by using place value blocks like this. So today I am going to subtract the numbers by using place value block. So if I want to subtract 4. So 36 minus 4. By using place value blocks, we have to subtract. How can we subtract? Can you guess anyone? Yes. So first we have to represent two digit number by using place value blocks. Then we have to subtract this number from these place value blocks. Subtract is nothing but we have to cut those many numbers. So first we have to write place values ones. Do you have tens in four? No, there are no tens in 4. So, we have only 1's place value. How many 1's do we have, children? 4 1's we have. So, how many 1's we have to cut? We have to remove 4 1's from 36. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many 1's did I remove, children? 4 1's. Because here we have 4 1's. From 36, we are subtracting 4 1's by using place value blocks. So, we have to remove 4 ones. And how many we have now? So, what we left? 1, 2, 3. 3 10 towers and 1, 2. 2 ones cubed. So, the answer is 32. So, what is answer, children? 32. When we subtract 36 minus 4 by using place values, we got 32 as our answer. Have you understood how you have to use place value blocks to subtract? Yes, first you have to represent the given number by using place value blocks. Then you have to remove the number. So now 48 minus 2. I have to subtract these numbers by using expansion method. Up to now what did we use, children? We used place value blocks to subtract. So that is very easy. We have to represent the number by using place value blocks. Then we have to cut the numbers. Yes? Now, this is expansion method. What is our S1, children? Today we are going to learn subtraction by expanding method. What is our S1? Subtraction by expanding method. So 48 minus 2 I have to subtract by using expansion method. In addition, we have learned expansion method to add. In this class we are going to use subtraction by expanding method. Now expansion method, how we can use, children? So first we have to take the number 48 and then we have to expand the number. So what is the expansion form for 48? Can you guess anyone, children? Yes. instead of tens place value, or we can leave this place value and plus how many ones we have? Two ones. So we have to write two under the ones place value. Where we have to write two children? Under the ones place value. Next. So next what we have to do? We have to subtract. So what is the symbol for subtraction, children? Minus. The symbol for subtraction is minus. Now, which place I have to subtract first? Tens place or ones place? Yes, ones place we have to subtract always first. So, from 2 we have to count to get 8. So, 2 after 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, how many fingers have I opened? 6 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fingers I have opened. So, 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. So, now, so symbol for expansion is plus. Now, 40 minus 0. So, when we subtract 0 from any number, we will get same number. So, 40 minus 0 is equal to 40. So, 40 plus 6 is equal to 46. So, what is the answer, children? When we subtract 48 minus 2, we got 46. So, what we will call 46, children? Yes, difference. The answer we get after subtraction is called difference. Yes, have you understood? 46 is our answer. How we have to use expansion method? First we have to expand the number. Then we have to subtract the numbers. So let us take another example to understand easily, children. So 53 minus 2. So we are subtracting 2 from 53. Which method we are using, Nana? We are using expansion method. So how we have to use expansion method? First we have to expand the number. So what is the expansion form for 53? 53. 53. So we have to expand 53. What is the expansion form? 50 plus 3. 53. So we have to expand the number 50 plus 3. Next take 2. And what is the expansion form for 2? Shall I write 2 under the tens place value? No. So there are no tens in ones in 2. So we have to put zeros under the tens place value and ones place value under. We have to write 2. So what is the symbol for subtraction? Minus. The symbol for subtraction is minus. So first which place value I have to subtract? Ones place value. So 3 minus 2. So what we have to do, children? We have to count from 2 until we get 3. 2 after 3. So we have to stop. So how many fingers did I open? 1 finger. So answer is 1. And bring less down. 50 minus 0? Yes, 50. So 50 plus 1 is equal to 51. So the answer is called difference. The answer which we get after subtracting is called difference. Have you understood, children, how you have to expand the numbers and how you have to subtract the numbers? Now let us take one example. So 35 minus 8. So we are going to subtract 8 from 35. So which method, Nana? Expansion method. So 35 we have to take and expand 35. 30 plus 5. Next take 8 and expand 8. 0, 0 plus 8. Now what is the symbol for subtraction? Minus. Now what we have to do? We have to subtract first ones place value. So up to now we have sufficient ones to subtract given number. Now 5 minus 8. So we have to remove 8 from 5. Means what happened here? Here we are subtracting more ones from small number. Big number from small number. So this is not possible to subtract, isn't it, children? So what did I say in before classes? Every time we have to subtract small number from big number, but we can't subtract big number from small number. So at this situation, what we have to do, children? We have to take borrow from the given below before number. We have to take borrow. So from 30 I'm taking borrow. So what we have to do means we have to cut 30. What we have to do, children? We have to cut 30 and we have to write before 10 from the 30. So before 10 means which 10 we will get? 10, 20, 30. value, so that 10 we have to add to the 5. So 10 we have taken from these numbers. So 10 and how much do we have here? 5. 10 plus 5. So 10 in my, take 5 fingers, 10 after 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So now cut these 5 and write 15. How much did we got? 15. So here we got 20 and here we got 15. So we have to, now we have bigger number. Yes children, now 8 is small number and 15 is big number. So now we can subtract these numbers. So count from 8 until we get 15. 8 after 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. How many fingers have I opened? 7 fingers. So 15 minus 8 is 7. Yes children, when we have smaller number up, we have to take borrow from the before number. Now, how much do we have here? 30 or 20? Yes, we have removed 30. So we have only 20 here. 20 minus 0? 20. So 20 plus 7 is equal to 27. Have you understood children? When we have smaller number up, we have to take borrow from the before number. Have you understood children? Everyone open your volumes now.
Yes, everyone open your volumes. Subtraction using expanded form. So first one, subtract the numbers. Hint, cross out as many ones and tens in as in the smaller number. Write the tens and ones left as the difference. Just now I have explained how to subtract the numbers by using place value blocks. So you can easily cut the second number from the first number. Next, go to the second bit. Subtract the numbers by using the expanded form method. So you have to use expansion method children. Don't be confused. So you can expand like how I explained on the board. If you want, take a screenshot and subtract the given numbers. Next, first one already completed for you children. Now move to the third one. Find the difference by using the expanded form method. Third one also you have to subtract by using expansion method only. But what is difference from second to third one? So from second one, we can subtract easily from big number to small number. But we can't subtract small number, big number from small number. So you have to take borrow from the before numbers. In third question, you have to take borrow and you have to subtract the numbers. So once again, go through the board work children. Observe carefully and take a screenshot. Then write your volume children. So have you understood? You have to complete the volume S1 children. And your homework is set 1 from page number 44.